about all the things you can do in your community to
share,
clean,
fix,
visit,
care,
give,
do.
Okay, have you got it?
Share, clean, fix, give.
Share, clean, fix, visit, care, give, do.
Share, clean, fix, visit, care, give, do.
Now go out there and do it.
Share, clean, fix, visit, care, give, do.
The big help's big because of you.
Big help.
Do.
No.
Clinky.
Look.
Nice.
This special behind-the-scenes look at Nickelodeon's Harriet the Spy is brought to you by Kellogg's Eggo Waffles.
Stick Stickley here on the set of Nickelodeon's first movie, Harriet the Spy. Thanks to my trusty notebook and the fact that I really blend in with the woodwork, huh, you're about to get an inside look at how a movie gets made. The stars, the crew, the plot. Anywho, I don't want to give too much away. After all, Harriet's not the only spy around here. Gentlemen, my trench coat.
Ouch!
Hey, what's that nose, pal?
Roll sound!
Stand by, everyone!
Action!
Cut!
Interesting.
Undercover with Harriet the Spy.
With host spy, Stick Stickley.
Boy with ringlets. Man with tattoos. Girl on a leash. I learn everything I can, and I write down everything I see, which is why I am a spy.
Huh, what a great idea! Harriet writes down everything in a notebook. So will I. That way I'll learn everything I can about Harriet the Spy.
I play Harriet M. Welsh, and my character's a spy.
Harriet, she's kind of a peculiar little girl because she spies on everybody. She'll do anything from looking in somebody's sky roof to running in the door while it's closing.
Score.
Harriet the Spy is about an 11-year-old girl who wants to be a writer, and so to learn about life, she chooses to spy on people.
I read the book in fourth grade, and I love that book so much. I really thought that they should make it into a movie, actually. I thought that Harriet's really like me. I mean, I love to read, she loves to read, I love to write, she loves to write. I love the way she spies, and I love to spy too. This is cool. And I love tomato sandwiches, and she just loves tomato sandwiches too. I just take out all the tomatoes and leave the bread and go, I'm done.
This is what I call chugging a tomato.
Hey, no tomatoes. Hey, I didn't get any tomatoes. I was like, whoa, if they made the book into a movie, I would try out for this part, like, definitely. And here I am.
Let's go.
Oh, Michelle is so cute. She loves tomato sandwiches. I love tomato sandwiches. Well, I could grow to love tomato sandwiches. Simmer down. Then there's Rosie O'Donnell. She's like big time. Golly!
This one, Vanessa, curses 24 hours a day.
Rosie's so much fun.
I say to her, Vanessa, could you please stop cursing? And she goes, you know, but I don't even want to say it.
All the scenes with Rosie are excellent.
This is the life of a movie star. It's 20 degrees.
Yes,
I'm in a summer coat, and I'm laying on the wet ground.
She's a kid. She just, like, grew, and she's just stayed a kid, you know?
Rosie makes every scene. Yeah, man, cool.
Don't do that when we're on the set!
Trick, judge, trick.
When they asked me to play Golly, I said yes right away. I think that Golly is really a childlike spirit in a grown adult.
Okay, quick, before it starts fizzing, shake it up, take a sip, and wish for what you want most in the world.
Golly is Harriet's nanny, a person who she trusts. I mean, her mother and father, she loves them very, very much so, but they never spend time with her. And the script is about how Golly helps Harriet. They have a really extremely close relationship. It's like this.
We're here.
What is this?
She gives everyone good advice, and she has ideas, and they're cool and stuff.
Golly, who's that?
That's Mrs. W, a very good friend of mine. Golly takes the kids to go visit this woman who is an artist who lives alone and creates art out of junk.
Wow, this is so weird. I've got some stuff in my garage this chime lady would love.
This is the wind chime garden of the wind chime lady,
where Golly takes Janie's sport, Harriet and Janie, to expand their horizons to new things.
And we're all sort of a little bit scared, you know?
At first, we all think she's a big freak. It's kind of unusual. But then we learn that she's actually very cool in her own little way.
The wind chime lady is kind of a metaphor for being true to your artistic nature.
Golly is very interesting, and she knows a lot about different stuff.
You're an individual, and you know something? That makes people nervous.
What do I do?
You stay true to Harriet, and you accept the cost.
Harriet's lucky. She's got Golly. She's also got the coolest spy gear. She has all these awesome gadgets. Hey, where are my gadgets? Props!
Spy belt is really cool because you have your flashlight and then you have your compact to spy on people. Mailman, 2 o'clock.
She's just really organized, I think, with her belt and everything.
This is Harriet's spy belt, and these are all her gadgets on it. These are my spy glasses. We have the flashlight.
Good.
Flashlight. And these are the playtex gloves. She needs them for protection because she can't have fingerprints. And then, most important of all, my notebook. The journal, it's something that's extremely private to Harriet.
Private.
Bye. Because she wants to keep all the records of everything that she spies about. She just wants it to be her own little secret. It's the beginning of the movie, and that's Honk Fat's food emporium. Harriet is, like, looking through crates at Honk Fat's. There's this woman with the purse. The guy steals her, like, wallet and is running. And he's running right for Harriet, but he sees her at the last moment.
Whoa!
And he runs straight into piles and piles of eggs.
Hey, camera only, marker.
Roll sound, please. Places, everyone.
Action.
He has to do it at least, like, 5 times. Once, like, the strong guy landed there and he was supposed to land there. Ba-boom! That was cool!
Oh, brother. Omelets for everyone! Sometimes making movies can get a little messy. Whew. Especially when they do so many takes. You know, that's when they start the whole scene over from the top and yell, action! Huh. Anywho, today I get to meet the kids who play Harriet's friends. She calls them the usual suspects. I call her unusually wonderful. Oh. Boy.
Sport and Janie are Harriet's best friends. They're really close.
Hey. Hey.
Vanessa Lee Chester. She plays a character named Janie Gibbs, who is totally obsessed with science. She's like a scientific weirdo.
It's a sulfur-based alkaloid. I want it to chemically fuse with combustibles.
And in English, that would mean stink bomb.
And she's basically a scientist, and she just enjoys blowing up things.
Janie, what is this supposed to be?
No, Mom, don't touch it.
Stop! What?
Because slime is, like, my thing, you know?
Janie's,
like, out there, outgoing. Yeah, man, cool. And Sport is more, like, humble, shy.
How does it look?
Give me the moose.
Sport takes care of his dad. He does the books, he cleans the house, he washes the dishes, but then he also has time for a good time.
Sixth grade. All the usual suspects are back in action.
Marion is like this little rich snob.
I'm like the devil. I am.
Marion Hawthorne. She's a little bit mean and a lot snotty.
But how come we get these pieces and you get those?
We need our strengths. You get to fix the clubhouse.
I play Carrie Andrews. She's the new pretty girl in school, and all the boys are supposed to like her. You know, it's kind of weird.
Carrie Andrews thinks she's cool because she spent her summer vacation growing boobs.
I'm gonna let you on a little secret, okay? Well, these are fake.
The character I played, he doesn't have a name, actually. Boy with purple socks. That's the character name.
We need a dribble. A drool dribble.
Sleeping and drooling, that was hard. I had practice at home. Like, every night I'd sit for about an hour, and I'd drool.
I play Pinky Whitehead, and Pinky Whitehead's meant to be a pale person, and he's sort of a geek.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Pinky Whitehead, the human fish belly. Pinky's DNA was combined with a pint of vanilla yogurt at birth.
I saw some of my buddies as extras in a scene with Pinky. They were all glued together in this house-like structure. It looked kind of painful. Maybe I should say something to the director. I think her name is Brown Wind.
Oh, Brown Wind is the best. She's like the best director in the world.
Great, that's what the shot is. Okay, sit up so you don't throw up.
She's very hip, very in.
She's got such a fashion sense.
Yes, okay. You all right? I wear a lot of hats because, you know, a hat makes you into a whole other person, so you get to change personalities every time you change your hat.
We call her Snappy because she always goes, okay, I want you to do that, that, and that.
You gotta make it snappy!
Snappy! There, go, you know, like, make noise so you help each other out, okay?
You know, you could tell she was a dancer, the way she moved.
Like, say if she asks us to, like, do more movement and, like, the dance.
You guys are in the front, you're all grooving out like this, okay?
She actually demonstrates this for us, so that's what really helps. Because then you can visualize it.
I think you're probably still in your defiant mode, you know what I mean? Like, you just threw the guy. Like, nobody understands.
Really, really.
Nobody understands you.
To be a director, you have to know where to put the camera and how shots are set up. And what I've seen, she's really good.
Could I have a reverse zoom here? Everybody!
She's got a great artistic sense and visual style.
Marker.
My mom said to pick the very best one, and you are it.
On the first day of shooting, she was like, do whatever you want, run, play, pop. And that was fun.
One of the most important things to me, especially working with kids, is that you create this sort of enthusiastic, positive environment. Hopefully that's coming out in the film.
Let's say I started laughing. That makes Greg laugh, which makes her laugh, which makes me laugh even harder.
Well, you can't come back. We're voting. It's official.
It's really fun because you can enjoy yourself instead of being really high-strung, you know?
She lets us give our ideas to make it more hip, like if we want to add a snap there or a... what's it called? A high-five there.
Brunnerin's the nicest person in the world. She really understands you.
I found out the director's name is Bronwyn. Boy, am I glad I didn't call her Brown Wind to her face. Huh, the kids in the movie really seem to like her. I wonder what kind of directors they would make. Hold that thought. So anywho, I was thinking about this idea I had, see?
What is it, Stick?
She just said my name. I'll never wash my ears again. I don't have any ears. I was thinking, you guys would make pretty great directors yourselves. All you need is a camera and a little inspiration. What do you think, huh?
Okay.
Cool.
Cool.
All
right. Hey, neat.
Hi, Vanessa.
Hi.
Zooming in on Vanessa's eye.
Why are you looking at my eye?
Hi, Bronwyn.
Hello. What up?
Nothing much, I'm spying.
Spying. Spy girl.
What are you doing?
No, but this whole dialogue takes place.
Ah, there you go. That makes you look kind of fat.
Are you recording?
Yep.
Excuse me. I need to talk to my lawyer before you videotape me, okay?
Oh, cool, Vanessa. I got you on special effects.
This is Vanessa, signing off.
The director says there's more action coming up right after this. You said that right. I'll be quiet.
Ah, summer. Vacationing with the family.
Please! Let me up, please!
Making new friends. Digging a 25-foot tunnel under your front yard.
Who said that?
Yes, these are the things that make summer special. And this Saturday night, SNICK's going to celebrate them. Join Clarissa, Shelby Woo, the kids from All That, Pete and Pete, for four glorious episodes that capture summer at its finest.
So what's the problem?
Don't miss the SNICK Summer Celebration this Saturday at 8, 7 Central, only on NICK.
Critics agree. The Hunchback of Notre Dame is a celebration too good to miss.
It will be fun.
This is a great film, raves Joel Siegel.
Come with me.
Entertainment Weekly calls it a towering achievement.
Hang on!
Four stars proclaims USA Today.
Quasi!
And Siskel and Ebert give two very spirited thumbs up for one of the best films of the year. Disney's The Hunchback of Notre Dame, rated G. Now playing at a theater near you.
Who's got the coolest music this summer? It's not your parents. It's not your teacher. It's not even the ice cream man. It's Coolio. Coolio's smash hit CD, Gangsta's Paradise, dishes out all your favorite flavors. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, something new, Gangsta's Paradise, and Too Hot. Coolio, Gangsta's Paradise. Scoop it up now.
Hey, Fred, King Tut Rock looks like you.
He filled his tomb with gold and Pebbles cereal, part of this good breakfast.
That mummy's no dummy.
But his tomb and treasure vanished.
We gotta find them.
These symbols could be clues. Barn? Somebody help! You can help Fred and Barney find my lost treasure with these glow-in-the-dark medallions. Each has a secret clue the guys need.
Cool.
One free medallion in my boxes of Pebbles cereal.
We're going for the gold.
Just make the call. You're a witty guy. Just pick up the old phone.
Put down the phone.
Ah! Okay, what am I so nervous about? Just, I've never felt this way about. Okay, just call. Hello? Yeah, I'm calling about TV Land. Well, don't get me wrong, I love my cable and everything, but I mean, Sergeant Bilko, Mannix, I mean, this new network from the Nick Knight people is really something special. So, can you put it on?
Don't be shy. Call today and say, take me to TV Land. Nickelodeon has the ultimate guide to modern life. Rocko's Modern Life. Chapter 1, Getting Your Own Place. Chapter 2, Keeping Your Place Neat and Tidy. Chapter 3, Making Friends with Your Neighbors. Chapter 4, Landing a Steady Job. Chapter 5, Taking Time Out to Relax. Learn about these subjects and more by watching Rocko's Modern Life. Every Sunday at 11:30, 10:30 Central on the only network for you, Nickelodeon. Chapter 6, Choosing a Pet.
Am I on? Am I on? Hello?
Yes, Dick.
We're back. There's a point in the movie where Harriet finds herself in a sticky situation. Hey, I can relate to that. Being a stick and all.
One of the horrible things that happens to Harriet is her friends find the book and they read it.
The only thing more pathetic than being Marion Hawthorne is wanting to be Marion Hawthorne.
Oh, Rachel.
There's some nice things about people and some mean things about people, but of course, I only read the bad things.
Laura Peters, her face looks totally pinched.
We had all gotten mad at Harriet because she wrote nasty stuff about us in the book. And so we all decided to get revenge. We built the Spy Hater Club.
I'm doomed.
And they start doing mean stuff to her. Like, they cover her in blue paint.
It was gooey, very gooey.
Strangest blue paint I ever saw. Nope, That's Blue, all right.
One of the kids comes up and she goes, "Oops, I'm sorry, Harriet." And then they want to get me worse, and they smear it all over my arms and my face and everything, and it's just like, ugh.
Stop it! I don't need your help! Be alone! Get away!
I get a paint bucket, and I go like, oh, it was just terrible.
I mean, it's cold, and it was sticky.
It went down my shoulder.
One more time, please.
I think I'll just stay right here where it's safe. Yeah. Hey! Whoa! I think they meant one more time with Harriet, not me! I think I may be getting a little too close to my spy work. I don't know what it is, but suddenly I'm feeling a little blue. Only kidding. I know I'll be in the pink in no time, because today I'm meeting Agatha.
No, darling. If you want to talk about something delicious, I have something delicious.
We were thinking about the role of Agatha K. Plummer, and then we cast Eartha Kitt, and I didn't know what we were in for because we had some wild plans for her with these wigs about 2 feet high and this sort of Marge Simpson head poof.
Oh, sweet Liberace, darling.
But when she got here, she was so into it.
I wish I could dream me like my sister Kate. I wish I could dream me like my sister Kate.
95 Apple, take one, Mark.
Action.
If it's that rat, kill it! She's an eccentric. It's a lot of fun, actually. I like this character. I am Agatha K. Plummer, darling. So when they said to me, "You must play the character of Agatha," I said, "Ooh, hoop-de-doo." What was that?
I have no idea.
Then why don't you go over there and get an idea? She feels Harriet around, and she knows that's a little snooper somewhere.
I'm spying on her.
Who wouldn't spy on her? I mean, she's Agatha.
I feel like a strawberry milkshake right now.
My maid will be running in any minute. My little doggie, Wee Wee, will be coming in also any second now. Oh, Wee Wee, come, give Mummy a kiss.
Wee Wee, you're cute.
He goes...
Nice doggy. Now, whatever you do, don't fetch a stick. Good, Wee Wee. Roll over. Play dead.
He's like the cutest little doggy in the world.
Didn't I tell you to play dead? Oh, huh, sorry. I think I hear my mother calling me. This spy thing can be really dangerous. Now I know how 007 feels. I'm pretty sure I'll be safe at Harriet's sixth grade holiday pageant. I mean, how bad can a bunch of dancing vegetables be? Lights, a camera, onion. That's right, onion.
One of the funnest scenes was doing the dance scene.
There was Miss Elson's sixth grade holiday pageant.
Pageant ideas.
A giant holiday feast.
And of course, Marion thinks of that idea.
There could be parts for everybody. Grains, vegetables, a shiny silver centerpiece.
You could play the barf bag.
Janie's a squash and sports drumstick.
I played a radish.
I was a tomato.
A big, fat, round one.
Wow. I'm a potato.
I played a lettuce. And me, I'm an onion.
Harriet's an onion.
An onion? Hello, I'm an onion, Harriet.
We had to go to a professional choreographer, and we had to choreograph the moves.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Production brought in this choreographer named Roland, and a choreographer is a guy or a woman that explains to you what certain dances are and how to dance to them and what music is right for you.
I thought festive. Vegetables are festive, so why not a conga line? Why not a limbo pole?
Come on. He would show us the moves, and we'd go through it. And, like, I'd never danced before, so I'd have to be in my head going 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And so eventually, we got fitted for our suits.
That was a really fun day, because you could see everyone in their costumes, or like really big costumes, really colorful.
Okay, now take it easy.
I felt pretty stupid with a big gravy on my head, like the side of Tokyo. It was huge.
Now pour your gravy on me, like on the drumstick. It's coating me.
What are you talking about? I don't know what's gonna happen. The good thing is, mistakes are funny.
The first thing was we would trot out in a very classical ballet way. And then Marion, the Miss Perfect, she would like do a little ballet dance. And then once the hip hop music, we just have to go down and start grooving.
And playback.
Get up off of that thing and dance to you, you better. Get up off of that thing and dance to you, sing it now. Get up off of that thing and dance to you, you better. Get up off of that thing and try to release that pressure. Get up off of that thing and shake to you, you better.
We just got to be like funky and dance and stuff. Plus, we got to limbo with a turkey baster over our heads.
You feel better. Get up off of that thing. Try to release that pressure. Get up off. Ha. Good God. So good.
What a show! What a movie! I can't wait to see the whole thing. I especially like the pageant. I wish I could have gone under the gravy baster. I would have gotten down so low. Or I could have played the perfect toothpick. Harriet's the cutest onion. Would you quit spying on me? I'm the one who's doing the undercover work here.
Break set.
It looks like my mission is complete. This is Stick Stickley signing off as host spy from Harriet the Spy, or as they say in the movie business, that's a wrap. Ha! Get it?
And action.
This seems very high on the gross quotient.
Anybody hungry?
Coming up next on Nickelodeon, it's Rugrats, followed by the one and only Doug.